ships, because the British came up to Chesapeake Bay, they went up to St. Michael's. The British went up to Harvard and Grace. The British went up to Chestertown. And all along these rivers, escaped slaves would row out and get on the British boats. But my point was is that my blood, sweat, and tears was here in America, and even though I was a slave, that I was still going to try to stick with the Americans. And so we all got together one night. We were on a boat, and we had a conversation. And I don't know if y'all have ever been on the water before, but your voice carried real loud on the water. So we had to talk soft. And if you listen quietly, you can hear what we was talking about. One of the brothers said, why should we stay here and fight with these Americans if we don't even have rights here? Why are we fighting with them? And then another one would say, but our foreparents, blood, sweat, and bones are in these soils. So why would we take a chance? So we just went back and forth, talking real quiet that night. And what happened was that almost 4,000 slaves had joined the British. But I remember one thing my grandfather said, because this is 1813. My grandfather said, this is not the first time that the British have offered this promise of freedom to slaves. Back in 1776, they made the same promise. And many of the blacks who joined the British ended up in a coal rock in Nova Scotia. And I told them that all these promises about going to the land of milk and honey was just not true. But some of them did go that way. But later on, I ended up fighting against some of the same blacks that I knew. And that was a hard time on the Chesapeake Bay. But then they had this man named Joshua Barney, and he was a commodore. And so he organized this group called the Chesapeake Flotilla. And with the Chesapeake Flotilla's job was to try to work interference to the British ships. And so we had a group, and he went around this Joshua Barney and then recruited black watermen, because black watermen knew the ways of the Chesapeake Bay. And so I decided to join up with Commodore Joshua Barney. And one of the things, we had some really tough fights on that Chesapeake Bay. I remember when we were down at St. Benedict and St. Lennox, and the British was on us real hard. And we had little small boats or barges, and we could go way up in the creek because the big British ships couldn't go that far. And so the British was after us, and so we decided that we were going to burn our boats and then fight, because Joshua Barney said if we burn the boats, it can't be no retreat. It's going to be no retreat. We're going to burn the boats, we're going to fight, and we're going to die. And so I was right there with Joshua Barney. So we fought with the British in Benedict, and then we went on to Bladensburg, and then there was a big battle in Bladensburg, and there is where Joshua Barney got shot in the leg, and I was standing right beside him when he went down. But I was just so mad, I said that if these Americans would stand and fight, we could have beat those British. But they turned and ran like sheep being chased by dogs. I was just so mad at them. So the Americans got beaten in Bladensburg. And then the British went on to Washington, D.C. And they sacked and burned Washington, D.C. They burned the White House. They burned the Capitol. But then their prize was Baltimore. So we decided that we were going to leave Bladensburg and then come back to Baltimore to defend Fort McHenry. And so, you all know about that night when Francis Scott Key was out on a boat, and he was writing the words to the song, Oh Say Can You See? And while Francis Scott Key was out on the river trying to free a doctor who had been captured, I was at Fort McHenry on the cannons. And as he was talking about, Oh Can You See? By the dawn's early light, we were back on our cannons. Boom! 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 And then he said that, oh, can you see by the dawn's early light, And then they were bombarding us over 20 hours that night. They just bombarded Fort McHenry. But we stood fast. We stood fast. And I wasn't the only black that was at Fort McHenry. There were three or four others, five or six others. And we just fought to defend America just like anybody else. And so one thing I want to tell you is that African Americans have been an integral part of the Chesapeake Bay. They've been an integral part of the War of 1812. And you might have heard of Francis Scott Key, but now you heard of Charles Ball. And I want these young people to remember Charles Ball. Charles Ball was an American hero. He fought for freedom right at Fort McHenry, right across the river. And Charles Ball is a name that you should remember. He started out as a slave. He was in slavery for over 50 years. And he lived a great life. And he was married and had children. And then even after the War of 1812 was over, Charles Ball lived in Baltimore. He bought land. He had a small vegetable garden. He sold produce. He married. But then one day there was a knock on the door. We got quiet. There was another knock on the door. It was the slave catchers back after me again. After I got escaped from South Carolina, escaped from Georgia, fought in Baltimore at the War of 1812 at Fort McHenry, and the slave catchers done caught up with me again. And this time they handcuffed me and carried me back to Georgia again. But I had a plan. I remember when I was in the Washington shipyard and we had a plan trying to escape to Philadelphia. And so there was a boat down there in Charleston Harbor, right outside of Savannah. And there was on a crate that said Philadelphia. I didn't know many words, but I knew Philadelphia. And so I got on that ship. A black man helped me get on the ship. And I got down underneath all the boards down where the cotton was laid at, because they were making cotton and then selling it to Philadelphia. And then I sailed all the way back up. But it was hot down in the hole underneath of this ship. And so I had a little piece of a biscuit, but biscuit ran out. But I was thirsty. I thought I was going to die. And I just cried out, God help me. And when I cried out, God help me, the captain said, who's down there? I said, it's Charles Ball. And the captain decided he was going to carry me all the way to Philadelphia. But I didn't know that this captain was part of the Underground Railroad. The Underground Railroad just wasn't on land. The Underground Railroad also ran on the rivers and the bays and the seas. I was in good hands. I got to Philadelphia. And when I got to Philadelphia, I decided to work my way back down to Maryland, where I left my wife and kids. And I went back down to that little cabin that we had. But when I knocked on the door, a white man opened the door. And my head just dropped. They said the slave catchers came and carried my wife and children away too. I was just sad and brokenhearted. And so I went back to Philadelphia. And that's where my story started, ladies and gentlemen. I'm an old man now at Mother Bethel AME Church in Philadelphia. And I'm just so glad y'all stopped by to hear my story. But one thing I will do, some of you may have questions about the life and times of Charles Ball. Charles Ball from Calvert County in southern Maryland, in between the Patuxent and the Potomac River. You might want to know something about my mama, brothers and sisters. I told you I love my grandpappy. But then we traveled down to South Carolina. We traveled down to Georgia. We were watermen, farmers. We was here, right here in Baltimore, Maryland, at Fort McHenry. So somebody might want to know a little bit more about the life and times of Charles Ball. So if anybody got a question or observation, I try my best to answer you. Yes, ma'am. The question was, did I ever find my wife and kids? I never found my wife and kids again. And when I went back to that cabin up there outside of Baltimore, up there in Joppa, and when people came to the door that didn't look like me, it was one of the saddest days of my life. I could hear the bombs bursting in there. There, can you hear? Is there another question?
Cannons. Just cannons.
Yes, ma'am. I got captured 3 times and I escaped 3 times. I was sold into slavery 3 different times for a total of 50 years. People talking about this movie just came out up here in Philadelphia called 12 Years a Slave by Solomon Northrop. Well, you heard my story, 50 years and change, and I got a story to tell too. Yes. Right now, I'm almost 55 years old and had a hard life. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for spending some time with Charles Ball this afternoon.